The first time I heard this sound by Victor Morello in Pigments, I was amazed because it's a percussive sound. Let's have a listen. Okay, so it sounds like a percussive sound sequence, but the sequencer is, as you can see here, is off, so it's not used. So that means that probably what Victor was doing was using some of those functions and maybe some random things or maybe LFOs to create the sound. Fine, but then I realized that those percussive sounds, which really sounded like percussions, basically, well, they were created by white noise. That's interesting, you know, because white noise is just a bunch of, you know, all the frequencies that you can create between a few hertz and maybe 20 or 30 kilohertz. It sounds like this. You know, you're playing all the frequencies at once. As you probably know, a sound usually is made of, it's always made of, for a given note in an instrument, with one sine wave whose frequency will determine the frequency of the note that you're playing, whatever the instrument you use. And then there will be a bunch of other sine waves whose frequencies will be multiple of the note frequency. And depending on the amplitude of each of these harmonics, so-called harmonics or partials, which are multiple of the note frequencies, you will create a special timbre. For instance, a piano and a flute will have the same A note at 440 hertz, which would be the first sine wave, also called the fundamental frequency. But then they will have a bunch of sine waves which will be added to that, and that the differences of the amplitudes of the harmonics in the sine waves will create a different timbre, and that's how you will recognize a piano, you know, an A note played on a piano from the same A note played on a flute. Now, once you know that, I had a look at what Victor was doing to create the percussive sounds with the various pitches in the percussions plus the percussions themselves. And I was really curious to see how he was doing that from white noise. And so I had a look and then realized he was using a white noise sample. And then I asked myself, you know, why is he using a sample? Well, in Pigments, the sample engine also allows you to use, you know, granular effects and also various features, modulations or unison chord feature, and one particular feature called the resonator. But anyway, in our case, let's again have a listen to what we get before we do anything with the white noise sample. Okay, now I'm going to use the resonator. The resonator, you know, it's a very vague name. And I looked at the manual in Pigments, and it was not very explicit. You know, it just said, well, it's using 6 passband filters. And I said, oh, okay, so then I start to understand, you know, what happened, because the first resonant filter will be used to select a band of frequencies and a very narrow band. So it's almost one frequency corresponding to a note that I'm playing. And then the 5 other filters, which are in the resonator, will just select the harmonics depending on the frequency of the main filter, which is used for the note frequency, for the fundamental frequency. And that way you can recreate a sound with a particular timbre. Now, as I said before, usually the harmonics, so the 5 other frequencies, should be multiple of the note frequency, but there are also so-called inharmonics. And these are frequencies which are not multiple of the note frequencies. And that's something that's very handy when you want to create metallic or bell sounds, because in a regular sound like an organ, for instance, you know, where the sound doesn't change over time, well, you can use this rule by Fourier, you know, telling you that, well, you know, a sound like this is made of one sine wave for the note and then sine waves with multiple frequencies. But in a harmonic will not be exactly multiple of that frequency. And that creates some those particular effects that you can hear in bells and metallic sound. And that's very interesting sound. So let's have a listen here by just increasing the amount of amplitude at the resonance frequency of each filter. And that will give us an idea of what we can create here. Very interesting. You can still hear the noise from the white noise, you know, the original white noise signal. But since you're selecting also a given frequency with the main filter, which corresponds to the note you are playing, and then, you know, some harmonics, it creates this interesting, pretty rich sound here. And now I can make the the frequencies of the partials vary so that they are not multiple of the original note frequency that we hear. And there we get very interesting effects. Etc. Now, as you know, the beauty of pigments is that you can modulate everything with almost everything. So that's what's happening in this particular sound here. And what we're going to do first is to make this inharmonic button here vary. And we're going to use function 2 for that, which is right here. And let's have a listen to what happens now, playing the same note as before. It's a C. Okay, so as you can see, the main note doesn't change, but the harmonics of the note are changing at a given pace, which is given by this function here. And at the same time, if we use a granular functionality, and we make the density of the grains vary at the same rate, then all of a sudden we get something interesting. As you know, the granular synthesis is just taking a given recording like that, a sample, and then taking some chunks of the sound and playing them at a given rate and at a given period. And that's what we do here, and we synchronize it to quarter notes. And here is what happens. Aha, you can guess where we're going now. And the problem is that for percussion, these have a too long decay. So what Victor did is that he was using the amplitude modulation here and use the same function here to create this very short decay so that it now really sounds like a percussion. Listen. Isn't that fantastic? I mean, it's, you know, all that from white noise, and it's very interesting. And then, of course, he cheated a bit. He added some effects and also added a sample here that you can hear. But, so far I've not used that sample, that second engine here. And then the final result is this. This is how you can use a resonator in pigments from a white noise sample to create very different sounds. And of course, there are many, many other applications for that. So just to summarize, the resonator is just a bunch of 6 passband filters. The first one can be tuned to a note, and the 5 other will follow and be either regular harmonics, which are multiple of the frequency of the main note, which is determined by the first filter, or will be slightly different based on this button here, and will then create much more interesting sounds.